Remember. Yeah. Remember, June 12 struggle. Is this? Yeah. Remember. Yeah. Remember Kudirat Abiola.
It's 18 years since the death of Kudirat Abiola, wife of the late Moshood Abiola, otherwise known as MKO.
When I remember Kudirat, I remember the struggle. Aye, what a runaway.
Civil rights group campaigned for democracy in collaboration with the Women Arise for Change Initiative and the Kudirat Initiative for Democracy gathered at her residence to mark the 18th anniversary of her death. Present at the gathering were children of the late Kudirat, Abdul and Hafsat.
I think that morning I thought something was going to happen, and I wish I was in the car with my mother, because I didn't want to go to school, but that doesn't mean I didn't want to go out. I actually wanted to follow her. So if I followed her, I think I might have actually stopped the bullet. But, and I think then we might not have all this going on now. I think things will have been a little better. But the fact that I wasn't able to do that then, because she forced me to go to school, I do intend on working and trying and looking for solutions to the many problems that we find ourselves in Nigeria now. I don't think it's really about what my mother is, that she's been gone for 18 years, but it's about what we've been able to do with that 18 years. 18 years is a long time.
Our government has to be present where the dangers in Nigeria are. They cannot be so far from the dangers, pointing fingers, blaming this and that. Nobody's interested in blame. We're just interested in solutions. There are problems in Nigeria. The problems are bigger than anybody. We know that it was not created by this administration, but so long as this is the administration governing Nigeria at this time, we expect the administration to solve those problems and to show that that's why they are there, not to give us explanations and reasons why they cannot. So on this anniversary of June 4, 2014, 18 years on, we say to the Nigerian government that people laid down their lives, not just Kudirat and not just MKO, but hundreds of Nigerian people. And if we count the thousands of Nigerian people who died just because the country has not been working, in fact, that number is in millions that have died because our country is not working.
Other pro-democracy activists also made speeches extolling the life Kudirat lived and the ideals she stood for.
Kudirat has taught us not to agonize, but to always organize for change. It's sobering that 18 years after Kudirat, terror reigns in our land. This illustrious daughter of Africa that paid the supreme price. We want all of us to imbibe all the virtues that Kudirat lived and died for.
What is the justice that the blood of Kudirat Abiola is crying for? That cry consists in the program of Chief MKO Abiola, which program was Farewell to Poverty. That was the hope that Kudirat Abiola wanted to achieve when her husband was incarcerated. The hope was abolition of poverty. There's only one contradiction which Kudirat Abiola wanted to resolve for the Nigerian society. And that contradiction is that the resources of Nigeria must be used for the welfare, for the well-being of the Nigerian people.
Kudirat was the beacon of the hope that was called Hope 93. Those who put out her lights did enormous damage to the psyche of Nigeria and continue in doing that. The people who are in government today continue forgetting the MKO Abiolas of this world, forgetting the Kudirats of this world. And those two represent the great number of people whose blood has been wasted so that Nigeria can become good for us all. For as long as they do that and keep forgetting that Nigeria has not achieved the hope that was crafted in this very compound in 1993. I don't see that Nigeria is going anywhere. So to Kudirat, I say, rest in the bosom of the Lord.
And then a wreath was laid at the graveside of Kudirat.
Her spirit challenges us, and we're here to pay homage and also to again renew ourselves, keeping in mind the sacrifice she made. As we lay this wreath, it is not an adornment, it's a burden for all of us and a responsibility for all of us, here or not here. That is why we lay the wreath. May her soul rest in peace.
Amen.
Following the annulment of the June 12, 1993 presidential election and the subsequent arrest of her husband, Kudirat fought tirelessly to get her husband free and restore his mandate. She would later die in that struggle. Meanwhile, Hafsat used the occasion to speak on her recent visit to Chibok and the ongoing Boko Haram insurgency.
It was very important to go to Borno because every day I'm sure you find the same. When you talk to people about what is happening in Borno and in the northeast region, people start talking to you about politics, that it's a political thing, that there's a conspiracy, that maybe state government people in different places are involved, or the region of the north, that there are people involved in the conspiracy. When I got to Borno, I don't know if there's a conspiracy. I can't tell that because conspiracies are by their nature secret. But what I saw was need. People being killed, victims of violence, whether from the army or from Boko Haram. I saw a state where the people are actually rising up to defend their state.
It's close to 2 months now since the Chibok girls were abducted, and the insurgency has continued to rock the northeastern part of Nigeria. Where Kudirat alive today? Perhaps she would have taken the same bold step to Chibok and join in the campaign for the rescue of the girls. Chidimma Chikeze, TV360, Lagos.